Hello everyone, this is Ella, your friendly advisor in Ireland. Welcome back to my channel, All About Ireland. In this video, I'm going to talk about the most important thing in Ireland for every employee. It's a payslip. In this video, I'm going to detail the payslip, explain what each of those fields are. And the payslip sample which I'm going to use is one of the most commonly used in Ireland. I'm pretty sure this will be very similar to what you have. And it's a mix of my both jobs and the values I used are completely hypothetical. And I hope this particular video helps you. And, you know, after you watch video, just look at your payslip, see if there is anything that is wrong or that you need further explanation. You can comment below or write to me at allaboutireland247@gmail.com for further explanation. Without further ado, let's just dive in. So for this one, for this particular video, what I'm going to take is this particular hypothesis where the annual salary is 61K and the monthly salary comes to 5083.33. The total tax credit is 5440. If you see the number, it's high, but I'm taking a person who has his wife here and she doesn't work and she shares, if she works, even she works, she shares her tax credits with him, and then there's a few more tax credits that he applied for. And the company matches 3% of the pension. Like if he contributes 3%, the company also contributes 3%. And the person also contributes 5% ABC, I mean pension additionally as voluntary contributions. And he also gets benefit in kind from the company towards medical insurance, and the amount is 347.44. Now, let me, with this as the basic, I'm going back to the payslip. So if you see here, you know, you usually have company name, employee name, department number, everything like that. And then here, if you see the values, with respect to values, you have frequency, which says whether it's weekly or monthly or hourly. Hourly is very rare, but you do see weekly payments. But in most of the cases, it's monthly payment. The pay period is 01. I'm just taking the January pay slip into consideration so that it's easy for everyone to read without further, I mean, without any cumulative values from months, which will lead to confusion. But yeah, open your January payslip for your own understanding, but you can also read any month's payslip after watching this video. You also usually have your PPS number, and usually the banks ask for payslips when they are giving you mortgage, and they look at the PPS number and then they match to the other documents, because that's one number which is consistently there in revenue documents and as well as your employee documents. And the pay date, as I said, I mean, I'm going with January as a pay date. If you see here, the salary is 5083.33, as said earlier, and the BIK medical is 347.67. And there is overtime section. And for this example, I'm not taking any overtime hours. If there is overtime, the tax and PRSI and USC will be also calculated on this overtime amount, and that gets added to PAYE PRSI USA. As simple as that. Now, if you see here, the gross pay under summary of pay is an addition of both BIK med and salary. From company perspective, this is a gross pay they are paying towards your salary as well as towards the other benefits they are giving to you as part of your package. So this is the gross salary, but it's not the gross salary that gets taxed. You a couple of minutes, you'll understand why. Now, if you come to this section here, this section is PAYE, PRSI, USC, and the pension contributions. And this happen on the salary, not the salary plus BIK med, because it's a benefit which the company is giving you. The taxation will happen on the salary which you get, right? So 5083.33 was the salary. So the PAYE is calculated on that. The PRSI is calculated on that. USC is calculated on that. For PRSI and USC and PAYE, you know how the tax rates are. You take a look at the video in the video description called Irish Tax System 2021. That will give you a good knowledge of how the PAYE is calculated. Usually, there's a little change on this. So for 2022, I'll be making a video clearly telling you how much pay you'll be paying in the new tax rate regime. But for now, this is the 2021 sample. So based on the percentages, these values get calculated for this period. And the balance, if you see here, this is the cumulative balance. As this is first month, you'll see both the values being equal. But let's say if you go to February, these values, you need to just add them up, like 678 spot. I mean, if you add them up, you'll get it in February, the same amount. So this will be double of this period amount in February, close to, unless if there is some change in your tax credits. And the, as I said, the pension contribution is 3% of the salary. 3% of the salary comes to 152.55. So that's the balance at the start of the year. And then you also have the additional voluntary contributions. He contributes 5%. The 5% of 5083.33 comes to 254.17. So these are the, these are the non-tax deductions. These are the tax deductions. That's how the revenue treats it. So to know more details, you need to come to cumulative details. Cumulative details is where it adds up every month and shows you how much tax have you been paying till that particular date. In this case, the gross pay is 503.83. Non-tax deductions is 406.67. So non-tax deductions are the pension contributions that you make. If you add 152.254.17, you get 2406.67. And not taxable pay is basically the gross pay minus the non-tax deductions, that is pension contributions. As I keep making videos on pension contributions, there's a video in the description that you need to take a look at on tax benefits when you contribute towards pension. Don't miss that particular video too. So you don't pay any tax on that, so the tax will pay drastically reduces. So it comes to 4676.66. Now, I said I have a tax credit of 5440, yeah. And if you divide by 12, you get to 453.34. You basically subtract this tax credit from the payee. The way it works is, now the standard cutoff is the cutoff till a point in the monthly pay slip where you cross the 20% tax standard rate. For example, as I said, it's a spouse thing. So I get 20% tax till 4-5 now, but yeah, it used to be 4-4-3-0-0 if I'm not wrong. So if you divide it by 12, you get to this amount, 3691.67. Till this amount, you pay 20%. Over that amount, you pay 40%. Now, if you add these up and you again basically subtract, you come to 678.98, which is the tax paid, which is payee paid in this particular month. It's as simple as that. For example, if you to arrive at the net pay, what you basically do is you subtract the salary, you subtract all this amount from salary. For example, this particular amount, it comes to 1459.6. It's both tax deductions and non-tax deductions. And then you subtract it from the monthly pay, which you get to net pay. But on the right, if you see, it's a bit different because this is for the company. It says it has given you 5431. The deductions on the tax and non-tax deductions on your salary is 1459.6. And then there is this non-tax adjustments because of BIK, which is 347, which gets subtracted from the gross pay. So the net pay is 3623.73. Here you also have tax rate and also total weeks that PRSI has been paid for, what class of PRSI you are in. This is also really important because if you pay PRSI for a few years, you get a lot of benefits. I'll probably be making a video on why we pay PRSI and what are the benefits we get because of PRSI. And on the right here under comments, you have the PRSI that the employer has paid. not the employee. So they played 561.7. And you also have what's the pension the employer paid in this period and also in this year. Same thing here. This is the period value. This is the total balance value. And also you have BI key year-to-date value that has been paid by the firm. So yeah, this is how you need to read your payslip. And if you have any questions, you can put a comment in the comment section. I'll answer them as quick as possible. If there is something personal that you need to discuss, you can write to me at allaboutireland247@gmail.com. And if you have any query-related queries, you can write to connect@careerisland.com. And yeah, I hope this video helps you. And keep subscribed to my channel. Keep sharing this video. And let me know if you need anything else.